So fashion really began with people making their own clothes. And they would get patterns and seamstress, or they would have a dress they already had, and it came a lot from function. Then there was specialized dressmakers. When things weren't just made within your home or if her mother couldn't do it, she would go to the dressmaker and have things made. But usually she was picking out the pattern and then buying the fabric. It was also a very popular thing to have fabric brought to you as a gift from the Orient or from somewhere far away, where you could still, that was the only way you could get certain hues because of the dyes, so like the purples and the deep blues. So that's what really began the upper class having the nicest things, because they could get things from all over and they had people making them for them. So it wasn't, the mom making it for her children. It was a specialized person doing it for high society and for the royal court. From that point, people did, put their own input in, but when it really came down to it, the people who made the dresses were much different lower class than the people who ordered the dresses. Charles Frederick Worth really made an impact in the industry. He's actually where the term couturier comes from. What he did was he worked for a drapery company, and he made drapes and he sewed things of that nature, and he got married and he thought a lot of his beautiful wife, and he had all the skill to sew, so he made her some dresses. When she started wearing her dresses in the showroom to model the curtains and to promote the curtains, people kept asking where the clothes were coming from. So that's how it started. How he really made his name was having the combination of personalities it takes to take someone who thinks they know exactly what they want and saying, I think that what's really going to work best for you is if we do it this way. And that's what made him special. He had already had contacts with a lot of hiring clientele, being in the industry he was, making custom drapery, and he was the very first person to put his tag, his name, his imprint in a piece of garment. So he knew that by making his name something that people wanted, he made history with it. But also, I mean, he had to turn away clients. And back then, for anyone to turn away work is just insane.